unfortunately a lot of people do is go into the pressure of making a false confession. So that's what they were trying to do for those four days.
To Andy's point, though, when you asked about it, I didn't even recognize him in that video. He's been through a lot.
He's lost a lot of weight. He's lost, I think, over 50 pounds. But again, put yourself in a situation where a father's trying to find his son, and this is the treatment that he gets. It's really, yes, he's lost a lot of weight.
More on Rob's point, tell me about the 50 pounds he's lost. How has that happened? Is he being fed well?
Certainly the stress does that. Duress, the fact that he can't get out and search for Codi. And he knows the police aren't searching for Codi because they're the ones that are creating this false narrative that he did.
This is maybe left field question. Is he on any type of a hunger strike?
No.
I mean, the court date is set for November 7th through 14th. The court will be closed on November 8th and also will be closed on November 11th. How is this going to affect his trial date? Having y'all to come to court, take a day off, come to court, take a day off. Is that fair to Cory Bigsby?
Well, that has happened. Like I said, Curtis has done jury trials that have gone straight through, that have had to stop. He's going to handle it.
So, how do you feel about Anton Bell, the Commonwealth attorney, saying he don't think we're going to even need all these days for this trial?
I don't care. I mean, I don't really care what Anton says.
Why do you not care what Anton says?
Because he's part of this scapegoat. Can you understand that? There's, for child neglect charges, and I hate to go back to the beginning, but what they did was they charged him with 7 child neglect charges for leaving his kids alone. There were no injuries. The media showed up at the preliminary hearing. There were no injuries. This is a case that should have been referred to CPS. Normally what happens is you refer the case to CPS. They go talk to him, put a safety plan in place. They ask what family members can come here. So this is a case that should not have been charged, period. And if the police say, okay, well, we're going to charge you with something, misdemeanor. They have misdemeanor contributing. So when the police were not able to get a false confession, I'm sure, this is my opinion, that they called Anton Bell and said, look, we can't get this false confession out of him, but we can't just let him walk out of here. What can we do? Anton Bell, didn't he say, again, I'm not saying he said this, this is an opinion, didn't he say he left his kids home alone? Yes, but that's only a CPS referral. Charge it as a felony. To me, the police did not do that without his advice.
And you're saying they did that because he's the main suspect in the disappearance of his son?
I'm saying that because they feel that he is the main suspect. And they have not done any work to find who really took him. Here's another thing. Where's the murder charges? Do you understand what I'm saying? If he was the main suspect, why isn't he charged?
And
so that's why I don't care what Anton Bell says, because I group him and the chief of police together, because officers generally call the Commonwealth attorney to get advice on what to do. And who charges 7 felony charges for children who didn't get any injuries? That's ridiculous.
That you mentioned to the public. I came into the press conference, and when you asked me, was I there in support of Codi Bigsby, and I said yes, why did you have me escorted out?
So the press conference was a conference that we did with the family. So I told the family that basically it was going to be the media. So the people who got invitations were the media. To be honest, I didn't even know you were there. It was a member of the family that alerted me, and I told the family, and I promised the family that it was going to be invitation only. People with the media, obviously, Rhoda got an invitation.
Yeah,
so
it wasn't that.
No. The family has been harassed by the public. The family has been let me tell you what the family's perspective. After the chief of police said the people who love Codi would stand up, they started going to their houses, they started calling them names, they started harassing them on Facebook. So the family has been very, the family has been treated really badly by the public.
Okay,
they don't
want to
be in public. So that's the point. Talk to the family,
they were invited to come.
I'm going to talk to the family. It might have been a different situation. No one has reached out to the family. Everyone is accusing the family.
No.
And because of, again, the Commonwealth had done.
Yeah, you're good.
I
one thing I want to say.
One question for you.